Hello everyone, I'm back again with the next video. As promised, I told you that in the next video we will be discussing about the different type of questions based on nature of roots. So this is video number 5 of chapter quadratic equations. So to continue with the questions, now the first question, the very first question or very first type of question is find the nature of roots of a given equation. Now try to follow this. I have taken 2 questions of it, and I think so that should be sufficient for you to understand. So then the first question is 2x squared minus 3x plus 5 equal to 0. Now here the value of a is 2, b is minus 3 and c is 5. Now we first find the value of b. So d is equal to b squared minus 4ac. Now we know that the nature of roots completely depends upon the value of b. So therefore we are to find the value of d first. So d is equal to b squared minus 4ac. Now substitute the values from here. B is minus 3, so minus 3 squared minus 4 into a is 2, c is 5. We get it as 9 minus 40, which is equal to minus 31. Now clearly we can see that minus 31 is less than 0. Therefore we write d is less than 0, which implies no real roots is possible for this particular equation. So that is its nature. B is less than 0, so no real roots. This is the nature of the roots. No real root is the nature. Now coming to the next question quickly. The next question is 3x squared minus 4 root 3x plus 4 equal to 0. Then again we write the value of ABC first and then calculate D. So the value of A is 3, B is minus 4 root 3 and C is 4. Now the value of d, again substituting in b squared minus 4ac, we have minus 4 root 3 whole square minus 4 into a is 3, c is 4, which comes up as 48 minus 48, which is equal to 0. So the second case also we have that when d is equal to 0, the roots are real and equal. So this equation, when simplified or when we are to find the roots of this equation, we should get it as equal roots. So this is its nature. And the third one will be when you will have the value of b greater than 0, that is the positive, because negative and 0 I have discussed. The third case that you can get at most is the value of b to be positive, and when the value of b is positive, you know that the roots are real and unequal. So that will be its nature. So this is based on nature of roots. We have only these 3 type of questions which are very direct, that is find the value of d and then state the nature of roots. So if d is less than 0, no real roots. If d is equal to 0, real and equal roots. And if d is greater than 0, that is positive value, then it is real and distinct roots or real and different roots. So that is all the 3 cases regarding nature of roots. Now what are the other type of questions? So I have taken up another question here, which I am reading it out because I have generally not seen it in the books. The question is, if the discriminant of the equation is 1, if the discriminant of the equation is 1, find the value of s. So this is s, you are given the value of b, you are given d is equal to 1, this is given to you. The discriminant of the equation is 1. So which is the equation now? The equation is 5x squared minus sx plus 4 equal to 0. So this is 5x squared minus sx plus 4 equal to 0. So this is the equation, and from here you have to find the value of s if the value of the discriminant is 1. So comparing it again with ax squared plus bx plus c, the value of a comes up to be 5, b as minus s, c as 4. We substituted in b as b squared minus 4ac, so we should get it as minus s whole square minus 4 into 5 into 4, which comes up as s square minus 18. So this is the value of the discriminant that we have got on calculation. According to question, what is it? It is s square minus 80 is equal to 1. Therefore, s square is equal to 81, and we are taking square roots on both sides, we get the value of s as plus minus 9. So this is how we find the value of an unknown when we are given the discriminant. Now here, please take note of the question of number 2 and number 3. In question number 2, the discriminant is given. In question number 3, nature of the discriminant is given. Now what is question number 3? find the value of k for which the equation has real and equal roots. Now you will have another condition also, that is when you have a, you will be asked to find the value of the unknown when the equations will be real and distinct. So there is one more question related with that. I have taken up one question which is where real and equal roots are given. This is more frequently asked. And the other one is not so frequently asked, but then you can, if you understand one, you will definitely understand the other. So we are discussing one here. Now the question is, find the value of k for which the equation has real and equal roots. I have taken a question of little higher difficulty level, because the simpler ones you can definitely do it on your own. It is very simple because you just have to find the value of d. So the question which I have taken up here is of a little higher difficulty level. Now this is x square minus 2k plus 1 into x. So coefficient of x here is minus 2k plus 1 and plus k square equal to 0. So now again comparing a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus of 2k plus 1 and c equal to k square. Now I am finding the value of b. B is equal to minus of 2k plus 1 ka whole square minus 4 into a into c. Now this one here you follow. This is the square of a negative. So I have directly taken it. I have taken this. We can consider minus as minus 1. So when it would be squared, the value will be plus. And then we find the value of a plus b whole square. So these are two terms. So when we square it, it will come as a plus b ka whole square. So a plus b whole square means 2k square is 4k square plus 2ab is 4k and plus b square is 1. So this is 4k square plus 4k plus 1 minus 4k square. Now the catch is here only in this simplification of this. Many times this the children they forget to put this as positive sign and therefore they don't know how to operate a minus sign here. So what eventually they do is they take minus inside the bracket. They simplify as minus 2k minus 1 and then you get completely confused as how to solve it. Don't bother about it. There's a minus sign and a square sign. This will automatically change to a plus sign. So just simply solve it as a plus b ka whole square. And don't bother about anything else. So now we take a plus b ka whole square and then we solve it. Once you solve it, you say that 4k square minus 4k square gets cancelled. So the value of b comes up as 4k plus 1. Now since for equal roots, d is equal to 0. This we know because the question asked is find the value of k for which the equation has real and equal roots. So if the equation has real and equal roots, that means the value of d positively has to be 0. So we then write the condition that for real and equal roots, d is equal to 0. That implies 4k plus 1. This is the value of d. So this would imply 4k plus 1 is equal to 0, which would imply 4k is equal to minus 1, and that would imply k is equal to minus 1 by 4. So this is how we find the value of the unknown when we are given the nature of roots. So in this case, you saw that the discriminant was given. In this case, you find the nature of the root was given. So this is the basic difference between the two. Sometimes you get this question. This is also a little higher order, but this is put in one mark question only. This would come for 2 marks or 3 marks. Because this is of a higher, greater difficulty level. Therefore, this question might come for 3 marks. Because simplification up to this step, identifying the values itself gives you 1 mark. Then simplification will give you another 1 mark. Finding the value of k will give you next mark. So this way, this is distributed in 3 different steps. First is to identify the value of a, b, c. Second is substituting and getting the value of b. Third is finding the value of the unknown. So this is how we may solve the different questions. The next part of the topic is your word problem, which if I get time, I will discuss through my videos. If I don't, please excuse, we will discuss it in the class, alright? So thank you.